Hello, Steven. Wonderful weather we're having, isn't it? Oh, I'm sorry. It seems I've forgotten your speech is a bit clouded. What? Me? I call myself the Weatherman. You see, I used to be a famous weather reporter, but as it turns out, I started losing faith in today's youth's ability to tell extreme weather conditions. So I was walking down the street one day, and I saw you. And I thought, I'm gonna ask this kid if he knows the dangers of the extreme weather conditions that could possibly show up in his town. And do you remember what you said? Do you? You said, "Get out of my face, you creep." Can you believe that? It was a simple question. So now? Now's your chance for redemption, punk. What makes you think I'm gonna listen to you? See this gun? I will kill you and your family and everybody you know if you don't tell me what you know now. All right, fine. Here goes.
Okay, well, I watch the news every morning, so it's pretty obvious that extreme weather phenomena are happening around the globe. I mean, hurricanes, tornadoes, floods, tsunamis, all of those things. People everywhere are being affected by them. I mean, we don't need a scientist to tell us the amount of damage a single hurricane or tsunami can cause. Remember Hurricane Katrina? The hurricane that hit the Gulf Coast in 2005? That one hurricane alone caused 1,500 deaths, and a lot more injured. Katrina had the second largest death count recorded in American history, but the first highest damage cost count, racking up at $84.6 billion in damage. In 1900, a hurricane greater in size hit one of the most important entry ports in the country at the time, the Galveston Bay. The Galveston hurricane caused over 8,000 deaths and holds first place in the list of most recorded deaths from a hurricane written in history. Hurricanes are a very destructive form of naturally caused extreme weather. They form to help redistribute the Earth's energy to other areas of the globe, and are formed by heat that accumulates over tropical and subtropical oceans that creates the energy that is then forced north by the atmospheric conditions to help create balance across the latitudes. Too bad that doesn't create balance for our pocketbooks with the damage it causes, right? Tornadoes, on the other hand, are less powerful, but more frequent. On average, there are at least 93 deaths a year caused by tornadoes. But averages aren't always a luxury we have. Some years are better than others, leaving the death toll from tornadoes at a measly 20, and some are more devastating, with the death counts reaching hundreds. Tornadoes, just like hurricanes, can cause extreme amounts of damage. They are caused by warm air and cold air combining. When the warm air rises and the cold air drops, they begin to form a spiral. This spiral continues to feed itself until it forms a funnel cloud. The sky turns a dark green color, and the full tornado forms and starts its havoc-wreaking campaign. Of course, tornadoes and hurricanes aren't the only forms of extreme damage-causing weather events. There are others, like tsunamis, extreme precipitation creating floods, and Justin Bieber fan mobs. But despite these events causing so much damage, the technology and ways of predicting them to be more prepared when they arrive has been getting better and better. In a book I read by John Banta one time, he stated that the extreme more violent nature of tornadoes and hurricanes has resulted in improved tracking and monitoring systems being developed for those areas where they are common. So, it would be safe to assume that the damage and death counts from these extreme weather conditions should decrease with each passing year and each advancement in detection technology.
My faith has been restored, and I will spare you and your family.
Thank you for showing me that I was wrong in losing faith in today's youth. Now run home. Run home to your family and tell them Rick Mecklenburg sent you.
Here's a jam for all the fellas. Try to do what those ladies tell us. Get shot down cause you're overzealous. Play hard to get females, get jealous. Okay, smarty, go to a party. Girls are scantily clad, are showing body. A chick walks by, you wish you could sex her, but you're standing on the wall like you was Poindexter. Next day's function, high class luncheon. Food is served and you're stone cold munching. Music comes on, people start to dance, but then you ate so much you nearly split your pants. A girl starts walking, guys start gawking, sits down next to you and starts talking. Says she wanna dance cause she likes to groove, so come on fatso and just bust a move.